On average, 30 million passengers cruise globally, on cruise ships which have evolved from just a mode of transport.
The ship itself has become the destination.
And this is the largest of them all, Symphony of the Seas. Constructed in 2018, costing over £1 billion, she weighs 228,000 tons. She weighs 228,000. The ship is 1,188 feet in length, longer than the Shard on its side. Its 18 decks stand at 238 feet in height, making it taller than Nelson's Column. With 6 engines, each the size of a double-decker bus, totaling 128,600 horsepower.
It's a marvel of technical engineering.
They even constructed a park that contains 20,700 tropical plants and 52 trees. This epic piece of engineering carries 2,200 crew members, who look after 6,680 guests, accommodated in 2,759 state rooms.
Everything will be picture perfect.
Below deck, the kitchens produce over 40,000 meals per day, and has a shopping bill just under $1 million per week, catering for guests that can seat 5,200 guests in one sitting. Welcome aboard the £1 billion cruise. The activities on board the world's largest cruise ship are endless, including a slide 10 decks high, towering 150 feet above sea level, 2 43-foot signature climbing walls, and a zip line 9 decks above a carousel which can tilt 5 degrees in any direction to counter choppy conditions at sea. If you happen to be a VIP guest on the busiest operational day in the cruise ship industry, it doesn't have to be hectic, thanks to their butler service role referred to as a Royal Genie. The Royal Genie is exclusive to the luxury suites on ship.
Well, here we are in the Royal Loft Suite.
The Royal Loft Suite can accommodate 6 guests, has 2 bedrooms, a dining area, and its very own grand piano. This room costs £75,000 for 7 nights. Another premium accommodation that comes with a Royal Genie is the Ultimate Family Suite, spanning over 2 decks and with its very own slide. Initially, guests are greeted by the ship's centerpiece, the promenade, which spans 2 decks and is home to shops, restaurants, and bars. One of them is a feat of engineering in its own right, the Rising Tide, the cruise ship world's first elevating bar.
You would naturally realize it was on a ship. It could be a world-class hotel. Being on a ship just adds to it. We have 35,000 bottles and cans of beer in 7 days. Ready here? Do you want to come? We have champagne selections. You have something to celebrate, you can buy champagne. You have something that you want to forget, you can buy champagne. And if nothing happens, buy champagne, something will come up.
But Emmanuel has no time for champagne, because he has one of the most responsible roles on the ship.
On the Symphony, we have 2,200 crew members. Half of them work under me for a thing. Inside with the waiters, I have 530 people working in the dining room. In the galley, I have 99 people washing and cleaning for the whole ship. And 257 chefs producing over 40,000 meals every day. The only downtime that there is in my operation is between 4 a.m. and 5 a.m. That's about it. Otherwise, it's always busy.
The staff members that Emmanuel need not worry about are the 2 robotic bartenders, which took 41,600 hours to create. Each robot serves on average 1,000 drinks a day.
The beauty of it is that you don't have an annoying bartender that wants to talk to you all the time, you know?